study the human respiratory system. The respiratory system brings about inspiration, expiration, exchange of gases and their transport. The gases transported into the lungs by the blood. From the blood, it brings to the tissues and different parts of the bodies. The respiratory system of man is divided into two parts, upper respiratory system and lower respiratory system. The upper respiratory system consists of external nares, then nasal cavity, internal nares, then throat and associated organs or associated structures. And the lower respiratory system consists of larynx, then trachea, then bronchi, bronchioles, and lungs. Thus, with the help of diagram, we study the human respiratory system, which consists the number of organs such as nose, pharynx. Pharynx leads into larynx. Larynx leads into trachea. Trachea leads into bronchi and bronchioles. Then lungs. And then alveoli. Then we study one by one all these organs. First, nose. Actually, nose having the external nostrils through which the environmental air is inhaled. It enters into the nasal cavity. It is divided into two chambers by a partition that is known as the mesethmoid cartilage or mesethmoid septum, which is made up of cartilage. Thus, the chambers are again divided into three parts. First one, vestibule, then conditioner, or it is also known as the respiratory part. And next, the chamber, that is sensory chamber. Like this, the nasal chamber or nasal cavity is divided into three regions. First, vestibule is the proximal part. Its skin has hairs for trapping the dust particles and filtering the inhaled air. Then second one is the respiratory part, or it is also known as the conditioner. It is the middle, highly vascular part which warms and moistens the inhaled air. And last one is the olfactory, or it is also known as sensory chamber. It is the uppermost part which is lined by olfactory epithelium for डिटेक्शन ऑफ स्मेल जे वासाचं ज्ञान जे आहे ते या पार्टमध्ये आपल्याला होतं. देन नोज कंटिन्यूज इन टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट, दॅट इज द फॅरिंग्स. दिस फॅरिंग्स इज अगेन डिवायडेड इन टू थ्री पार्ट्स. दॅट इज फर्स्ट वन इज नोन ॲज द नॅसोफॅरिंग्स. देन इट कंटिन्यूज इन टू द ओरोफॅरिंग्स. इट इज अ कॉमन पॅसेज फॉर फूड अँड एअर. अँड इट कंटिन्यूज इन टू द laryngopharynx. In between the nasopharynx and oropharynx, there is a palate bone. Again, the pharynx has a set of lymphoid organs that are known as tonsils. Then pharynx continues into the larynx. Larynx is commonly called as a voice box. It is commonly called voice box. It is present, or it is part of respiratory tract which contains vocal cords and for producing the sound. The larynx extends from laryngopharynx. It is hollow tubular structure. Its wall is made up of cartilaginous plates which are held by membranes and muscles. Internally, it is lined by pair of folds of elastic vocal cords. The voice is produced by passage of air between the vocal cords and modulations created by tongue, teeth, lips and nasal cavity. The larynx opens into laryngopharynx through a slit-like opening called glottis, which is opening of the trachea, or it is also known as windpipe or windpipe, which is guarded by a leaf-like flap called as epiglottis. That is, the glottis is covered by epiglottis and it prevents the entry of food into trachea. Then next part, that is the trachea. It is a tubular structure of about 10 to 12 centimeter long. It runs through the neck region in front of esophagus up to the middle of thoracic cavity. It is supported by C-shaped incomplete cartilaginous rings, which prevents the trachea from collapsing. It is lined by ciliated pseudostratified epithelium and mucus glands, which traps the unwanted particles and thus prevents their entry into the lungs. Then the next part, that is the bronchi and bronchioles. The trachea divides into right and left primary bronchi. As it reaches the middle of thoracic cavity, these bronchi are internally again supported by the C-shaped cartilaginous rings. The primary bronchi again divided into secondary and tertiary bronchi and continues into the, or it leads into fine branches known as bronchioles. It continues into the alveolus. Then the next part, that is the lungs. Lungs are the respiratory organs, main respiratory organs. Pair of lungs are present. These are spongy and elastic in nature. These are present in thoracic cavity. Each lung is enclosed and protected by a double pleural membrane. Outer layer is known as parietal layer and inner layer is known as visceral membrane. In between these two membranes, pleural cavity is present, which is filled by pleural fluid, which is lubricating in function. It is secreted by membranes. The right lung is somewhat larger than the left lung. Right lung has three lobes, while the left lung has two lobes. Each lobe of the lung has terminal bronchioles ending in a bunch of air sacs, and each with 10 to 12 alveoli. And then the last part, that is alveoli. It is a grape bunch like structure. It is lobulated, thin walled, and surrounded by network of capillaries of pulmonary arteries and veins. These have highly elastic wall made up of squamous epithelium, which are resting on the basement membrane. There are about 700 millions of alveoli present in both the lungs. The alveoli are the structural and functional units of respiration, as the gases are transported, or exchange of gases takes place at the alveoli level. So in this way we study the human respiratory system with the different organs. But one more part is there, which is related with the respiratory system, that is known as diaphragm. So this diaphragm plays an important role in the process of respiration. Rather, it is important for the mechanism of respiration, that is, it is important in the breathing mechanism, while the processes known as inspiration and expiration takes place. That means the diaphragm is a septum, or it is a partition of muscular tissue. It is made up of tough tissue, and it is the partition between the abdominal cavity and thoracic cavity. Totally, there is a partition in body, transverse partition in our body, through which only the esophagus runs through this. That means a partition known as diaphragm. This diaphragm is actually dome-shaped like this. We study all this in the process of breathing mechanism, or inspiration and expiration. This diaphragm is dome-shaped, and while it contracts, it becomes flat like this. So all these parts are important regarding the process of respiration. That's all.